measurement of the cooling tower. What is mean by first of all the cooling tower? Cooling tower is an example of simultaneous heat and mass transfer operation. The principle of cooling tower is the evaporative cooling. The sensible heat of the water is utilized for the evaporation of water itself. In industry, we require the cold water. In the process, the water is going to be heated. That water need to be cooled. Suppose the 30 degree Celsius water is there and we need to reduce down the temperature up to the 15 degree Celsius. Then how we are going to reduce the temperature of that water? That is done by using the cooling tower. Now there are different types of cooling towers. The classification is, one is the atmospheric cooling tower, next is the natural circulation cooling tower, next is the forced circulation cooling tower, and another last is the induced draft cooling tower. In the atmospheric cooling tower, the air is passed in the all directions which is in contact with the water, and in the natural circulation, the pressure difference is created for the inlet air and the outlet air. Because of that, the water is getting cooled. Next is the forced draft cooling tower. There, the air is going to pass from the bottom or the side. Either we use the blower or the fan at the bottom or at the side of the cooling tower equipment. In the induced draft cooling tower, the fan is used at the top, which sucks the air fastly, and you will be getting the performance of cooling tower greater. The induced draft cooling tower is having the highest efficiency than that of the natural circulation cooling tower, than that of the atmospheric cooling tower, and than that of the forced type of cooling tower. This is the experiment of the induced draft cooling tower. See, this is the main body of the cooling tower. Okay, the air is through the blower, we are going to pass the air. Okay, then here the water is going to enter from the top to the body of the cooling tower. See, at the below, the water tank is there. That water is going to be passed through the motor. Okay, the flow rate of the water we are going to measure over here. The geyser arrangement is provided to heat the water. Okay, that water, heated water, is going to enter from the top up to the cooling tower. The hot water is going to fall from the top to the down, and the bottom, the water is collected into this tank. The water is going to be recycled. Okay, the air is going to enter from the bottom. Okay, and air leaves at the top. See, at the top, the fan is provided. The induced draft fan is provided at the top. That's why this cooling tower is called as the induced draft cooling tower. See, here the mesh structure is provided. Okay, one is horizontal direction, then another the perpendicular we are going to put over here. These are the mesh. Okay, this increases the surface area for the mass transfer, and also we are getting the heat transfer surface area more. The residence time for both water and the air increases. That's why you will be getting the performance of the cooling tower high. Okay, now what is meant by the performance of the cooling tower? The performance of the cooling tower is in ratio of heat output to the heat input. Heat output is nothing but the mcpdt for the air, and mcpdt, and mcp heat input is nothing but the mcpdt for the water and the air. Okay, now see, you are having the air which is going to be entered. This is nothing but the driver temperature of the air. This is the vapor temperature of the air. This is the inlet temperature, thermocouple sensor, inlet temperature of the water. This is the outlet temperature of the water. See, at the top, we are going to measure the driver temperature and the vapor temperature for the air. So, at the inlet as well as the outlet of the air, we are going to measure the WBT and the DBT. From that, by using the psychrometric chart, we are going to measure the humidity. See, water is in contact with the air. Okay, the outlet of the air is having the increased temperature. The heat is going to transfer from water to the air, and at the bottom of the column, you will be finding the reduced temperature. So, heat output, that is with respect to the water difference, and the heat input is related with the air temperature difference, mCp dT for the water divided by mCp dT for the air. See, the danger alignment is there. This is the digital temperature indicator which gives us the various readings of the temperature, that is inlet temperatures of the air and inlet the outlet temperatures of the air, then inlet and the outlet temperature of the water, which gives us for the calculation of the mCp dT. From the Paris handbook, we can measure, you can take the specific heat of the water and the air at the respective temperatures, and flow rates of the air and the water we can take over here. See, this is the orifice. Through this, we are going to calculate the flow rate of the air, and by using this rotameter for the water, we are going to calculate the flow rate of the water. This helps us in calculating the values of mCp dT. Once you know the temperature readings, we can calculate the heat output as well as the heat input, and you will be getting the coefficient of performance, that is COP for the cooling tower, and COP value is higher for the inlet of the cooling tower. Thank you.